Welcome back, peeps. We got another battle against the Calgary Nitro Strikers this week. Should be pretty good. I don't have a team builder for this week, unfortunately. I've just been really busy. Even though I came off my bye week, I kept myself busy with non-Pokemon related things, so not really anything to go on with that, but I'll just be giving us a rundown per mon, and hopefully we can pull out a W this week. I'm really looking forward to it. We finally broke into the top 10, so if we can keep the win streak alive, that would be awesome. And I've seen our opponent's team. He does have some threats, but hopefully we'll be able to overcome them. And it looks like the Glalie's not here, which is awesome. I've kind of already planned to lead with the Gigalith, and hopefully we can do some things like set up, get some rocks up. His team is very attack heavy, so we are bringing an iron defense set, so I'm really looking forward to that. And good luck to our opponent. And he's going to lead off with the Steelix, which I'd say is good for us. Not going to overthink anything here. Just going to go ahead and go for, yeah, the Iron Defense would be better. We are specifically EV'd to outspeed this thing. So hopefully if he's min speed, we go first. And we do, which is great. So we're just going to start setting up here. He's going to set up rocks. Not bad, not bad. Let's see, for this, I actually think we're going to go ahead and get one more. I am really scared of that Rillaboom. And we should be able to, at this point, we should eat anything the Steelix has for us. The high horsepower is going to come out. And yeah, we eat that like a champion. So at this point, I'm going to take the opportunity to go ahead and get our rocks up in return. I definitely am glad we're faster here, just in case he did have the Iron Head, he could have the chance to flinch us out. And I'm just going to go ahead and just go for the body press here. And he might live. Yep, sturdy, it looks like. I'm going to take another high horsepower here. And I'm actually, let's see, I have to worry about the Porygon Z in the back. I am going to go ahead and get up our last iron defense before I knock this Steelix out. He's probably just going to sack it. And I need the plus 6 to really deal big damage to the Rillaboom. Psychic things, okay, interesting. He's going to get a crit. Nice crit, nice crit. And we're going to lose our Sandstorm, unfortunately. But I think we're in a good position to just go ahead and click rest right here. And since we are rocking our Chesto Berry, we're instantly going to get back up to full health and wake up. All right. And we are in full position. Oh no, and then a crit. Oh, that's too good. Alright, well that's a little unexpected, but hey, I'm setting up in front of him. It's bound to happen. I'm going to click rest again. That's unfortunate. I wasn't planning on just sitting here like this. I'm clicking my moves quick since I am kind of running a more stall-oriented set. Not so much stall, I mean my intent is to sweep him, but I have to burn through these two turns of sleep first. So he is going to get chip on us. Hopefully we don't see another crit come out, that would be very unfortunate. But I did not rule it out. I don't think, even with this thing set up, that I'm going to win. But hopefully the plan with this is to eat through one or two of his mons. Maybe even stop his Dynamax. We'll see. And then we wake up, of course. Body press, and the Steelix is gone. And honestly, I think his best move would be to send Porygon Z out here, because I feel like we might be in range of Hyper Beam. But we'll see what he decides to do here. Yeah, Porygon Z. And this thing should be sashed. If I predicted him right, he comes out onto the rocks, though. And we should live whatever he's got. So I'm just going to... I hope we live whatever he's got. I think this does about 60% max. But I'm just going to go ahead and hit the body press and hope we live. Oh boy. Survey says... And we do. So this should be the Porygon Z gone. And to me, even if he brings something out to kill the Gigalith at this point, I feel like it really has done its job, because the Porygon Z was one of the more threatening members on his team. Having that Hyper Beam, that adaptability Hyper Beam in your pocket is just insane. Pinsir's going to come out here. We're at max defense here. Let's see, we could go for body press, or we could just rest. I think I'm just going to go for body press. It might not be the play, but okay. I'm really glad I didn't press rest there. So we are going to get some good damage on this thing. He's swords dancing, so that tells us he's not scarfed. He's not... even if he is, even if he does set up here, even if he goes for a Dynamax... we should be able to pick up the kill with our sock in the back. He's going to close combat. I expect that to kill. Shout out to him with the swords dance. I did not expect that. And it was definitely a little scary. More than a little scary. Alright, so we got no reason not to just go out into our Choice Scarf sock. We're running Choice Scarf this week because it lets me outspeed his Obstagoon and the Porygon Z, as long as they don't have their respective scarf, and I feel like it's going to work out for us. I think I'm just going to go for knockoff here, just in case he switches, but, you know, why would you switch this thing out? It's just going to die to rocks. Oh, it had King's Rock. Interesting. I did wonder what he would run on his Pinsir. Whether it be like a Choice Scarf Moxie or something of that sort. And then here comes the Luxray. He has been known to Dynamax this thing, so I definitely am worried about it. But most of our team is very specially bulky. Physically bulky. So I think our most advantageous play, especially if he does go for the Dynamax, is just to go out into our Shenotic. What's he gonna do? And we do see the Dynamax from the Luxray. So we're gonna see how much damage this thing does to me. Not sure if he'll load up something like Psychic Fangs, Wild Charge, but we're about to see right here. As long as I eat it up nicely, I should be able to Spore. Max Mindstorm comes out. Okay, good. Ooh, that is going to do some big damage. And let's see. After Leftovers Recovery... we could potentially live another. I'm just going to go ahead and Strength Sap here. If we die, we die. I knew his Dynamax was going to be a problem. Quick Claw. And Max Lightning. We should eat that up since it's resisted. Yeah. And when we should get close to max HP with the Strength Sap. And hopefully this will help us stall out his Dynamax here. Oh yeah. So now I think our play, I'll just Spore. Throw off a Spore. He goes into Rillaboom, good prediction, but, and then the Quick Claw is going to go again into the Hailstorm. Okay, this is strange. I kind of would have expected that last turn, but it looks like we eat it up enough that I don't think it would have mattered, Lightning versus the Hailstorm. Oh, Electric Terrain! Yo, what a good play on my opponent's part. I didn't even think about that. Oh, gosh. Well, he got me there, but that's going to be the end of his Dynamax. So this thing is going to be a lot less scary. He didn't get any boosts. I'm just going to go ahead and Strength Sap again, because Ice Fang will probably come out, or Fire Fang. Okay, wow. Yeah, I figured Strength Sap would help us here. You know, if we were able to live a hit from him, we could weaken him with that Strength Sap, so we could live hits like that, like the Max Hailstorm, like a Fire Fang. And he's pretty weakened now. I think we're just going to go ahead and start hitting him with moves like Giga Drain. I'm really not too worried about this Luxray at this point. If he switches out into something, we can handle that later. But I think Giga Drain would be a good click against just about everything on his team, barring a Rillaboom switch in. And he is going to switch out, probably into the Rillaboom, right? Great Friend? Oh yeah. There's Harambe. He's going to eat this Giga Drain like a champion. But we have ways to deal with this thing, so I'm not too worried about it. His Dynamax is already gone, so I don't have to worry about this thing's Gigantamax form. And I think we're just going to switch out into our Skuntank here. Oh my gosh, all these animations. I know there's been a lot of timer controversy. So, I knew with the sets like the Gigalith I was going to run this week, I was going to have to play a little quicker. So, that's my goal. Alright. And what did you go for, my guy? Drum Beating. So, we should take that pretty well. Yeah. And then Black Sludge Recovery, too. Okay, and then I'm not sure which one does more over Foul Play or Sludge Bomb, but at this point I think I'll just... Actually, if I remember, this thing is Assault Vest, possibly? So I'm actually going to go for the Foul Play. Oh, and this should be doing a good chunk against me, unfortunately. But we should do a good chunk with Foul Play. Oh yeah, that's actually going to take it out. Oh, we got a crit. I'm not sure if it did matter. I could have Sucker Punched after, but, you know, that's very unfortunate for my opponent. But chances are whatever he sends in here, we'll just be able to get the KO on Skuntank. Not too worried about conserving Skuntank, since literally it was here for that Mon. He's going to send in this, and I'm actually going to take the opportunity to Corrosive Gas here, because I can get rid of that Flame Orb before it pops, potentially. Oh, he's going to Obstruct. I should have expected that, because I know he's been running Obstruct on this thing. And then, yeah, we do corrode the Flame Orb. So thank goodness I didn't hit him, or we would have had those defense drops. And then... with there not being much I can do here, I'm just going to click Sludge Bomb again. I could switch out, but not too big of a deal. And we live it, because we are max defense. Get some good damage on that. I don't think there's a real reason to conserve differentials here. But it's fine. We'll just keep whittling them away, because Sock can just come in and pick up the KO. And I believe he has... this in the back. I can't remember.
What was the last thing he had? But Choice Scarf Sock is going to be tough to beat here. And depending what he's got in the back, I'll have to see what I'm going to choice myself into. Oh, he still has the Luxray in the back. Okay, great. So we can just go close combat and pick up anything he's got. So this is going to drop our defense. I wouldn't say it mattered too much. Sock is not meant to eat hits, especially with our sturdy broken and with a choice scarf. We're more worried about outspeeding than anything else. Close combat's going to come out, and Sock's actually going to pick up some kills this week, which is great. Love to give this thing some action. We got a critical hit there. I can practically guarantee you that did not matter, but it's okay. If that was on the Luxray, that might be a different story. And then I don't remember what percentage this thing's at, but he's going to take rocks damage here. We might pick it up. You know, we are running, I can't remember if we're running Jolly or Adamant, but we did sacrifice a lot of our sheer power this week for speed. So we'll see if I'm able to KO the Luxray, or it could be Scarfed and surprise me. But we do go first, and he's going to live it. And with our minus two defense, I would be so surprised if Sock actually lives anything this thing has. Of course, the Psychic Fangs, and I'm gone. Good deal. And does he go down to poison? Oh, he does. So that's going to be the battle over right there before Inteleon can come out and pick up the kill. Shout out to my opponent this week. Really good match. And I was really happy to be relieved of my boredom from my bye week, so it sucks that I have to wait until next week to battle my next opponent, which I believe is the Indiana Tracers, and I'm really looking forward to that matchup. Alright guys, I'll catch you later with some more TPL action.